That was beautiful. Good morning, friends. Good morning. It is lovely to see you this morning. I'm Gwen. I'm the Director of Education and Communications here. And it was with love in my heart that I say, whoever you are, wherever you're from, whomever you love, whatever it is you have done, you are welcome here. You are welcome here and you are loved here. Valerie Kaur is someone who knows a lot about love. She is a renowned Sikh activist, filmmaker, civil rights lawyer, and author of See No Stranger, a memoir and manifesto of revolutionary love. After the 2016 election, an election that left many people feeling like our country was a hopeless and loveless place, Valerie Kaur was invited to speak at a historic Black church in Washington, D.C. And this is what she said. The future is dark. But what if this darkness is not the darkness of a tomb, but the darkness of a womb? What if America is not dead, but a country that is waiting to be born? What if the story of America is one long labor? What if all of our grandfathers and grandmothers are standing behind us now, those who survived occupation and genocide, slavery and Jim Crow, detentions and political assault? What if they are whispering in your ear, you are brave? What if this is our nation's greatest transition? The crowd erupted, and over the roar of the crowd, she continued, what does the midwife tell us to do? Breathe. And then push. Valerie Kaur extends this metaphor of labor in her book, writing, love is a form of sweet labor. Fierce, bloody, imperfect, and life-giving, a choice we can make over and over again. Love is labor can be taught, modeled, and practiced. This labor engages all of our emotions. Joy is the gift of love. Grief is the price of love. Anger protects that which is loved. And when we think we have reached our limit, wonder is the act that returns us to love. So, love is an action, and not always an easy one. So often, before we can really show up for love, we have to pause, we have to breathe, and then we are able to push. Today, our service is sweet labor. We will have moments for breathing and stillness. Time for you to find the internal resources that you need to engage in radical revolutionary love. And we will have time to put love into action. Another chance to engage in radical love together as community by choosing the action you feel called to. What a way to conclude our month of radical love. All right, now we're gonna light the chalice if any kids wanna come forward and help me. So now, in a moment, we will all move to different places in our church building where we can participate in three different activities together rooted in love. Downstairs in our common room, I will be leading a creative and colorful time of making Valentines for our local nursing home, Coastal Manor, right on Main Street. Set up in the gathering room, Faith in Action Council members have set up paper, pens, envelopes, stamps, everything you need to write letters to the Yarmouth Town Councilors on behalf of affordable housing, the Affordable Housing Committee's zoning proposals. And upstairs here in the sanctuary with Sam, he's going to be teaching harmonies for We Shall Overcome, a song that you can learn together to sing and then perform as our offertory at the conclusion of our service. And lastly, for our friends on Zoom, Joanna will be posting information about the affordable housing letter writing campaign, and Sarah will be taking you all on a tour of these various stations so you can see what's happening. We hope, assuming it works. So given time constraints today, you're going to be spending just 15 minutes doing these actions today. We ask that you choose just one station to participate in. We can also give you information about writing Valentines or doing letters at home. Okay, let's take a deep breath. Set an intention for this time together. And on the count of three, let's put our love into action. One, two, three. All right, let's go.
Want to join the choir or come make a stick?
Now I'm going to go downstairs and see what's going on with the letter writers. I hope we can stay connected. Coming down into the gathering room.
These talking points, I highlighted the ones that are the most, are the easiest talking points to include in your own letter or to add in your own writing on a mock-up letter. And the rest of the points explain more about what this is all about.
So is the goal to take these home and write them on our own stationery or cards or whatever?
Absolutely. Or you can work on it today if you have your own. I have some blank pieces, blank paper over there. If you'd like to write your own today. And this also includes the how to if you want to do it at home on your own.
Oh, okay,
so,
great.
And, but is
yes, the, yeah, okay, yeah.
The best thing is to have a hard copy in town hall or just email, okay?
Email is okay. The Affordable Housing Committee and Aaron Swerko, their town employee responsible for planning, has asked us to anyone in town who's interested in affordable housing to speak up and let the town council know that there is an outpouring of interest in the topic. And if the town council doesn't hear that, they're not going to want to be supportive of when the planning board puts forward this inclusionary zoning proposal.
So it doesn't matter how we contact them.
Yeah.
I assume since I live in Cumberland that they're not interested in my opinion.
The Yarmouth Town Council is not, but your town council is. Where you find that information is you can go on the Cumberland website and find the information about your town council, and you can send an email that way.
Great.
Or a letter.
Yeah.
And you can use the same words because the problem is scaring away.
Yeah. And there's lots of options. You could sign one of these letters. Just put your name on one, or you can take one home and draft it yourself. You can mail it by paper. You can drop it off at the town hall. You can you can send an email. But we would love to have copies of what you send because we might, you know, put together a set of all of them. So that's just if you can do that, that would be great. But if you can't,
send that
back to Marge or to me, and we'll put them all together.
Sign.
Yes.
You could just sign this one today. Okay. Oh, this one here.
Do you have the
board? Yeah, if you click on the website, there's there, and there's one link you can click that sends an email to all of them.
Okay.
Yeah. So, or then it gives you their individual email.
So if I Google Yarmouth Planning,
Yarmouth Town Council.
Oh, just the Yarmouth Town Council.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I'm talking about the actual planning committee now.
Okay. Planning board. Also, all their emails are on the website.
Okay.
Yep. Okay. Or you can send it to Erin Zorko, and she'll give it to everybody. Okay. She's the one responsible for the planning board. Nat Tupper is responsible for the town council. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And then there's Megan Casey, former counselor, who is the chair of the Affordable Housing Committee.
She's chair.
Yeah.
Thank you so many calls.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You can certainly contact your own town and tell them.
Well, you actually can use a lot of this information except for the Yarmouth.
Yeah, those are apartments.
I haven't changed going on.
Now I'm going to go down the hall and see who's making Valentine's.
We can help you. We can help you.
Hello. Hello, hi, everybody. We're making Valentine's here. You know, Eva Thompson's daughter, Kayla, her little boy, Oliver, made a really cute Valentine. It was sort of a collage, and it said, "I love you to pieces." And there were all these little torn up pieces. So cute.
Okay,
so
sure, have
it looks good.
Yes. Good. Yes. See, delivering all kinds of yes, Valentine wishes.
Oh, there's more over there. That how long the there's blue.
You want some
everybody want to say hi to the people on Zoom? Hi to the people at home. They wish they were here making Valentine's. Oh, you guys got the fancy scissors.
You want to write your name or no? Sure. What would you like to write?
Brenda lost color twice.
Oh, really?
Once over Christmas and once on that really, really cold night. Good lanterns. Oh. You know, Arwen was concerned when we lost power. When did we lose power?
If you asked, you
it was that get... same storm, but I think ooh, earlier in that storm.
To make your voice go out. We don't have full light on.
Yeah, I know. Somebody has to come fix the wires, right? They have to fix the electricity wires.
I can.
Oh, call up CMP. I bet they need more workers.
That's the spirit. That's the spirit.
Yeah.
Where is Springport? Right on the edge of the village. Tory Hill.
Yes.
Yeah. My name's Porter Beans. Another girl and I would go walk. Oh, it's not like this and then focus down.
Yeah.
We could do it when we were in shape. Yeah. Not anymore.
Oh, that's
funny. It is. Used to go to the moors.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah. Could you hear that wind? It was so loud at our house. We could hear it. We could hear the wind. It sounded like howling.
Yeah.
Did it sound like that at your house?
Yeah.
Now I'll go back and check on the letter writers. Some people are going to write a letter and send it from here. Some people are going to take the talking points and go home and work on their letter. Anyone who wants to make a letter can check the order of worship where Gwen attached all of these sample letters and talking points.
Sorry, but you can see, you know.
There were 72 people sleeping in the shoe.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah.
It got worse.
And I think some years ago, the last couple of months, the average
average?
Because there's so few for sale, partly.
Hey, Buddha. Hey, good boy. Hey, good doggy boy.
But she has a sister that she sees, and she has come visit, or she goes and visits her. I bet it is.
Go back upstairs and see how the choir is coming along.
Especially if they just as well. All right, we'll try again. And I'm going to try to sing melody. This should throw you off. So just try to hang strong. That's the tenor part. Just stand with all of my choir singers here. Yeah, just stand right inside of all of them. They're all going
to
be
far away to do you a favor.
No, I want. They're good. They know what they're doing. How do you feel? You get enough in there? So when in doubt, just sing.
So I'm just picking a note that sounds good. And just try to not sound bad.
You got it.
But you are
Some people, for to better hear their own voice, will cover their ear, and it makes it so you hear more inside your own head. So if you want to try, we'll do it one more time. Try that. Cover your left ear so you can listen to it.
Listen to what your voice sounds like with one ear covered.
How was it? You're not grabbing an alpha note, you're grabbing other notes that are about. So I would trust your ear and just sing the words in whatever one of those pitches you just heard. So let's try this out. We're gonna do the whole thing one more time, and I will sing melody again. One, two, one. Okay, which verses should we do? I don't think we should do all four. How about back there? Which verses should we do?
Welcome back, everybody. We're coming to our seats again. Singers included, come to your seats.
Thank you.
think there are more people coming from downstairs. Yeah. Let's give them another minute. Right. I mean, important people are missing. We're going to wait a few minutes.
Okay.
And then we'll go to our offering.
Try to stand.
It's very hard to ask people to move and then come back. Mobilizing bodies. Here they come. Valentine makers, letter writers, singers, everyone's coming back. Marge, is there anyone else downstairs? Oh, good, okay. Just to follow up on where we were, in case our internet connection dropped, we broke into three groups. Some people learned to sing the harmony for We Shall Overcome, which they'll offer in a few minutes. Some people went to write letters about affordable housing, in Yarmouth, and some people went to make Valentines for Coastal Manor. And you can still jump in and probably sing. You can still jump in and make Valentines for Coastal Manor. You can still write letters for affordable housing. So if you weren't here today, or if you wanted to be in all three places, you can kind of do that. And now we'll make our offering. So honoring our commitment to care of our earth, we share our plate today, or half of our offering, with Maine Climate Action Now, drawing together climate action and youth organizations and affected communities from across Maine. YCAN offers education and action opportunities seeking to amplify the voices of youth and others historically excluded from the climate conversation. Holding social, racial, and economic justice as critical to the transition to zero carbon emissions, MCAN demands the equitable implementation of clean renewable energy, ecological land use practices, and bold community-led action for a more resilient Maine. So you can make your offering in the plate today, you can click on the donate button, and you can always get a check to the church some other way if that works for you. So now Sam and the choir will offer us this song. Do you want to say something about that?
Yeah, absolutely. So I had everyone here learn a harmony part, so I actually do need melody singers. But there's a condition. If you're going to sing melody, keep an ear open and make sure you're balanced with the harmony part. So don't just scream out the melody and think that that's the most important thing. We all know harmony is just as important as melody. And so we're going to sing We Shall Overcome, which is in your hymnal if you want to pull that out. It's number 169. And we're going to sing verses 1, 2, and 4. Anyone who wants to come try the alto harmony, you can join this party up here. Anyone who wants to sing melody, we need like at least six of you.
Come on, melody.
Great.
Come on, melody.
Thank you.
Let's sing our song of thanksgiving. Thank you for all gifts given and received. At this point in the service, we make time for quiet and for the offering of our joys and sorrows and concerns. So today, if you'd like to light a candle and speak to that joy or sorrow, you'll be invited to do so. We do not record this time in our worship, so that your privacy is respected. And if you'd like to light a candle, you can line up along those windows and come to this mic, tell us your name, the essence of your joy or your sorrow, and then come light a candle here. If you want to light a candle silently, that's always fine too. And join us in singing our closing hymn. We'll go through it maybe twice. Okay, Spirit of Life, with feeling. 123. Thank you. You may remain standing and join us in our unison benediction in your order of worship. For those who come here seeking God, may God go with you. For those who come embracing life, may life return your affection. And for those who come to seek a path, may a way be found and the courage to take it step by step. Thank you. You may be seated. Enjoy our postlude, A Kiss to Build a Dream On by Louis Armstrong. And then we'll see you downstairs for coffee hour.